by the government and non-governmental organizations like Rotary Club, Lions Club, etc. Some of our awards include National Award for Teachers by Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, the President's Award, Sarvottam Acharya Award for Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, New Delhi, Award for Outstanding Woman Social Worker from Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce Ladies Organization. These are just to name a few. May I now request Madam Vijayam Kartha to kindly address the gathering.
Yeah, namaste. Good morning. It's a privilege to be here amongst all of you. Congratulations to Bhavan's Pune Kendra for its anniversary. My daughter is a teacher. The first day of her school, she entered the classroom and she made an announcement. She said, "History is an interesting subject." Promptly, one student stood up and said, "No, ma'am, history is a boring subject. That's what our previous teacher has told. You have to mug up facts. You have to, it's of no use learning history." So today we are again revisiting history, the birth anniversary of two great men our country has seen. We have a choice. Either we can just pay tribute to these two great men, or reflect upon what are those things which we would like to inculcate in us from these great men's lives. I'm sure year after year we are doing that, but year after year we have to reflect, I feel, whether we are doing it, whether we are implementing, we are living these values in our lives. Normally we keep talking about inculcating values in children. I feel more important to for us to look within whether we live those values, because an empty jar can't fill the other jars. So what do these two great men teach us when we
Madam, by mistake you are on mute. Can you please unmute?
I'm so sorry. Nobody told me, and I kept on going. I'm so sorry. Okay. Once again, I'll start. Thank you for this opportunity, and it's my pleasure and privilege to be here amongst all of you. Congratulations to Pune Kendra for yet another anniversary. And I was just sharing about my daughter was a teacher. On her first day in her history class, she announced history is an interesting subject. And promptly one student stood up and said, "No, ma'am, history is a boring subject. That's what we have been told. You have to mug up facts. You have to mug up dates. It's very boring. And we don't learn anything from history." So today we are reliving history. History, when we remember the Gandhiji and Lal Bahadur Shastriji, we are remembering, we are reliving our history, history of our freedom struggle, the sacrifices these two men have done for our country. So we have a choice. We can pay tribute to these two men and then go on. Like, okay, yet another day has passed on and life goes on as normal. Or we have a choice to reflect upon the values these two great men stood for, whether those values have still relevance in our lives. That is something which we can think of, especially as teachers, I feel, because we keep talking about instilling values in our children, and it is these are some days which you know we can really use to check in, to do a fact check whether we live those values in our own lives. Why are these people even relevant today? Definitely we remember them with a lot of gratitude for the freedom they have got us because of people like Gandhiji and
gone on mute. Please unmute yourself, ma'am.
It is going on mute. I think somebody is muting me.
Probably, yes. I'll just...
Please tell the host to not to mute me. They must be muting everyone.
Yes, ma'am. You can continue.
So... I was saying, why are they relevant even now? They are relevant for the values they stood for, values like humility, honesty, authenticity, simplicity, dedication, you name it. Gandhiji and Shastriji exemplified all these values. They were two great examples of simple living and high thinking. And Gandhiji had clear-cut ideas about what Indian education should be like. He talked about the all-round development of the students and an education based on, revolving around art and craft. I'm so happy that national education policy have brought in some elements of Gandhiji's dreams into the policy, vocationalization and again importance to art and craft, etc. Some of the and features of national education policy also the importance to the local community. Gandhiji always believed in a holistic education in which the community was actively involved. And coming to Lal Bahadur Shastri, some of his achievements we are all aware of. He got into freedom movement when he was hardly 16. And it seems when he had to, dropped his caste title when he was in standard 7. And Shastri is not a title. It is the, that was the qualification he got after he completed his graduation. And we also hear that during his wedding, when they insisted for dowry, he had asked for a charkha and a set of khadi clothes. And it seems when he died, he did not have anything. He hadn't any property or anything other than some books and a few clothes. It also, there's an interesting story, I'm sure most of you must be aware. He did not even own a car when he never allowed his children to use the official car. So they bought a car on loan, and the last installment of 5,000 rupees had to be paid off from his pension by his wife after his demise. Imagine a person like Lal Bahadur Shastri lived in this country. And I think every politician can look into his life and get some inspiration. There are so many stories. He was the first person as a transport minister who appointed women conductors. He resigned when there was an accident which happened as a railway minister when a train accident happened, owning moral responsibility. The stories are so many. A person who... led the country to a win against Pakistan, who coined the famous slogan Jai Jawan Jai Kisan. A person who before suggesting something to the countrymen, he did that in his own life. For example, when there was a shortage of food grains, he asked the countrymen to go without food for a day, but he did it his own family first. What a beautiful life. So many values which we can you know, we can keep talking, we can keep reflecting how many of it we have. We have a choice. We can ask our children to give a talk on Gandhiji's, on Shastriji's life, or we can ask them, what are those values which are still relevant for you today, which you would like to implement in your life? Now, these are some of the things which I think we should do during occasions like this. Now, lastly, I would like to end with, what can some of the actions what can schools do to propagate the ideals of Gandhiji and Shastriji? I remember once my students had gone for a residential camp, and when they came back, I asked them, what did you learn? So the students told me the greatest lesson was, ma'am, there was a Gandhian who came to speak, and he said, if every Indian buys 2 pairs of khadi clothes a year, it will provide employment to so many villages. And that led us to take a decision that all teachers will wear khadi on every Monday in our school. Our students also wanted to emulate. They requested me, we would also like to go for a khadi uniform, which I couldn't do because of so many reasons. Another practice I feel is, why should we have invigilators for children? Gandhiji, you know, shares that beautiful example of how, in spite of his teacher asking him, he did not cheat in a small test. So can we inspire our students to appear for examinations without invigilations, showcasing their honesty and truthfulness? Can we adopt a village, you know, at either 1 kilometer radius of our school for development? Maybe an association with a rural school where we can help them to develop. You know, these are some of the, you know, Gandhiji always believed, and I know we all believe in it. India still lives in its villages. And I think people like us, we are better off, have to reach out to the villages to help them to be self-sufficient. And you know, I can go on and on, but I'm sure we would like to hear more from our honorable chairperson. Thank you so much. And I enjoyed the songs by the teachers. It was a wonderful morning. Thank you so much. I pay my homage to the memory of Gandhiji and Lal Bahadur Shastri. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam, for your kind and inspiring words. It is my proud privilege now to introduce to you Srimati Leena Mahindale, the chairperson. She is an IAS retired. She has studied physics, project planning, MBA, she is, and she has also taken the degree of LLB. Madam was the Chief Information Commissioner. She has also worked as IAS in Maharashtra, up to the chief secretary level. Madam is known as a teacher, philosopher, physicist, thinker, writer, traveler, orator, and administrator with social outlook. Madam has worked in the areas of rehabilitation of Devdasis, women empowerment, education, naturopathy, energy conservation, animal husbandry, and rural development. Madam has written 25 books in Hindi and Marathi on various subjects like administration, child literature, environment, etc. May I now request Madam Leena Mahindale to kindly address the gathering.
Namaskar. Ratna ji ko bahut bahut dhanyawad. और आप सबों को नमस्कार. मैंने हिंदी में आरंभ किया है और मैं थोड़ा हिंदी, थोड़ा मराठी, थोड़ा अंग्रेजी, इस तरह से थोड़ा मिक्स करके मैं बोलना चाह रही हूँ, क्योंकि आज का दिन ही कुछ ऐसा है जब हम 3 बहुत महान बातों का पुण्य स्मरण कर रहे हैं. पहला श्री गांधी जी, जिन्हें हम बापू कहकर के पुकारते हैं प्यार से, शास्त्री जी जो हमारे प्रधानमंत्री रहे, और भारतीय विद्या भवन की पुणे शाखा जिसका आरंभ भी 2 अक्टूबर को हुआ था। तो 3 बड़ी हस्तियां हैं आपको मेरी आवाज आ रही है रत्ना जी?
यस मैम आ रही है।
तो किसी ने अपना ऑडियो म्यूट नहीं किया है तो उनकी आवाज भी आ रही है बीच बीच में, तो सबों से रिक्वेस्ट है कि अपना ऑडियो काइंडली स्विच ऑफ योर ऑडियोज। या धन्यवाद।
कैन आई रिक्वेस्ट रुतुजा बिब्वे टू म्यूट हरसेल्फ? रुतुजा बिब्वे
तो पुनः एक बार सबको नमस्कार करके मैं कुछ अपने विचार आपके सम्मुख रखना चाह रही हूँ। No doubt that the Pune Kendra of Bharati Vidya Bhavan is running 2 very beautiful schools, which are English medium schools. But let us take the example of Bapuji, Shastriji, and the founder of Bharati Vidya Bhavan, Shri K. M. Munshi Ji. And also the founder of this Pune Kendra, Sri Yardi Ji. All these people were very keen that the Indian languages should be developed, or they should be allowed to progress as much as the other languages all over the world. So there is a great relevance of learning English, and also great relevance of learning the languages of our own country. और इसीलिए मैं मुझे बहुत आनंद होता है जब मैं देखती हूँ कि अभी जो यहाँ भजन प्रस्तुत किए गए या भारतीय विद्या भवन का जो थीम सॉन्ग प्रस्तुत किया गया, सारे में हमने अपने देश की और मानवता की बात कही है। अभी मुझे लगता है कि मैं गांधी जी के ऊपर बहुत बड़ा भाषण तो नहीं देना चाहती, ना ही शास्त्री जी के ऊपर, लेकिन दोनों की एक बात बहुत ही आज के तारीख में बहुत ही सुसंगत है, और वह है उन दोनों की सत्यनिष्ठा। और जब हम भारतीय विद्या भवन की बात करते हैं तो इसमें जो शब्द है भारती, वह भी भारत की संस्कृति को इंगित करता है। और भारत की संस्कृति में अगर कोई मुझसे पूछे कि एक शब्द में भारत की संस्कृति का वर्णन करो, केवल एक शब्द में, तो मैं कहूंगी सत्यनिष्ठा। सत्य के प्रति निष्ठा, यही है भारत की संस्कृति। इसीलिए हम बार बार कहते हैं सत्यमेव जयते नानृतम्, सत्य की ही विजय होती है। अब यहाँ हमारे टीचर्स हैं भारतीय विद्या भवन के चाहने वाले, बहुत लोग सुन रहे हैं, तो एक बात मैं और आप लोगों के साथ मेरा विचार बांटना चाहती हूँ कि सत्य का क्या महत्व होता है। मैं इसको 2 तरह से देखती हूँ। पहली बात कि जब हम बोलते हैं तो सबसे पहले हमारे मन में विचार आता है, और जो मन में भावनाएं आती हैं वहां से मन में आए हुए विचार, वहां से उन विचारों का प्रकटीकरण जो हम भाषा के माध्यम से करते हैं, और भाषा के माध्यम से हमने जिसको प्रकट कर दिया उसके साथ अगर कोई क्रिया जुड़ी हुई है, कोई एक्शन अगर उसके साथ जुड़ा हुआ है तो अंतिम चरण में हम वो एक्शन भी करते हैं। इसका अगला चरण भी है, उसकी तरफ मैं बाद में आती हूँ। और ये अगला चरण है एक्शन ले लेने के बाद हम उसके फल के प्रति भी सोचना आरंभ करते हैं। तो शुरुआत करते हैं कि हमारे मन में उठने वाले भाव तरंग, वहां से हमारे मन के अंदर विचारों का प्रकटीकरण। तो ये दो चीजें हमारे शरीर के मन के अंदर होती हैं, तो उनमें एक सूत्रता होती है, उनमें आपस में कोई दुविधा नहीं होती है। लेकिन जब हम उसको वाणी का स्वरूप देते हैं, जब हम बोलते हैं, तो हमारे सामने हमारे अलावा बाकी बहुत सारे सुनने वाले होते हैं। तो कई बार ऐसा हो जाता है कि हमारे मन में भाव एक है लेकिन हम बोलते कुछ अलग हैं। तो ये समझिए कि हमने जिस काम को पहले किया मन में विचारने का, उसी काम को हमने दोबारा किया कि दूसरों के सामने हम किस तरह से बोलेंगे। और जैसा हमने बोला वैसा अगर हमें नहीं करना है, हमें कुछ तीसरा ही करना है, तो हमें उसी विषय पर और एक बार अपनी एनर्जी खर्च करनी पड़ती है। तो इसीलिए हमारे यहाँ बार बार कहा जाता है कि जैसा सोचो वैसा बोलो, जैसा बोलो वैसा करो, मनसा वाचा कर्मणा, ये हमारी सीख होती है। तो सत्यनिष्ठा की पहली कंडीशन ये है कि जो हम सोचें वही हम बोलें वही हम करें, तो हमारी ऊर्जा की बचत होती है। और जब हमारे अंतरूनी, जो हमारी अंदरूनी ऊर्जा है, द इनर एनर्जी, इफ वी आर एबल टू कंजर्व आवर इंटरनल एनर्जी, देन वी कैन बी ब्लेस्ड विथ अ लॉन्ग लाइफ। सो व्हेन वी से इन आवर कल्चर जीवेम शरदशतम, लेट मी लिव हैप्पीली efficiently with workable energy for 100 years, तो वो workable energy कहाँ से आएगी अगर हम अपनी energy को झूठ बोलने में खर्च कर देंगे। तो सबसे बड़ा फायदा तो सच बोलने का ये है कि हमारी energy सेव होती है, हमारी life span बढ़ती है और हम अपना life बहुत खुशी से बिता सकते हैं। बहुत स्वार्थ की बात है कि सच बोलो तो आपका स्वार्थ सिद्ध होता है। अब दूसरी बात, सच बोलो तो जो समष्टि है, यानी हमारा समाज है, हमारा राष्ट्र है, उसका भी स्वार्थ कैसे सिद्ध होता है। तो इसका छोटा सा उदाहरण है कि मान लो मैंने इस गणित को सीख लिया कि 2 और 3 मिलाकर के 5 होते हैं। अब मैं किसी और को झूठ मूठ अगर मैंने बताया कि सुनो सुनो 2 और 3 मिला करके 9 होते हैं, उसने सुन लिया, उसने मन ही मन कहा अच्छा ये मेरे से झूठ बोल रहे हैं, ओके ओके मैं भी आगे झूठ ही बोलूंगा। तो वो तीसरे आदमी से जाकर के कहता है कि सुनो 2 और 3 जो हैं वो 17 होते हैं। अब मान लो वो तीसरा आदमी बहुत भोला भाला है, उसे पता नहीं है कि एक्चुअली 2 और 3 5 होते हैं, तो वो जाकर के और 4 लोगों से कहेगा कि सुनो सुनो 2 और 3 जो है वो 17 होते हैं। तो इस तरह से जब समाज में अलग अलग बातें पसरेंगी, तो जब मान लो कि ये सारे 4-5 व्यक्ति इकट्ठे हो जाते हैं तो उनमें झगड़ा ही होगा ना। एक कहेगा कि 2 और 3 5 होते हैं, दूसरा कहेगा नहीं 2 और 3 9 होते हैं, तीसरा कहेगा नहीं 9 और 3 11 होते हैं। तो जब हम सच बोलते हैं तो हमारे ज्ञान का विस्तार अपने पूरे समाज में, अपने राष्ट्र में, अपने ज्ञान का विस्तार बहुत अधिक प्रभावी ढंग से होता है, जलद गति से होता है। तो जब हम कहते हैं कि हमें बच्चों को, बच्चों के साथ हमें अपने अनुभव को बांटना है, अपने ज्ञान को बांटना है। हेलो, इज समवन ट्राइंग टू टेल मी समथिंग, प्लीज प्लीज से इट अ लिटिल लाउडली।
No, someone is talking. I think Galaxy A30. Someone is talking.
Okay.
Please mute.
So, anyway, let me continue. So what I was saying, that when, I have a whole lot of teachers of Bharati Vidya Bhavan today before me. And the teachers know it very well, much better than I know, that when they are teaching, they are trying to teach what is the real fact, what is its good interpretation, what is its effective applicability, and all these good interpretation, effective applicability, success through the knowledge, all of it is dependent on getting your facts correct and getting your knowledge correct. So when we are dealing with the children, the teachers are most careful to say the right things, to teach the right lessons. But the same also applies in our day-to-day life when we are talking to each other. And therefore, whenever we are talking the truth, we are adding to the knowledge bank of not only ourselves, but also of the entire community, the entire nation, the entire world. So, speaking truth is for myself, my own health, my own coherence. Am I coherent in my thoughts and my language and my work? If the answer has to be yes, then I have to follow the path of truthfulness. यही बात बहुत बहुत सरल शब्दों में गांधी जी ने कही, यही बात बहुत सरल शब्दों में हमारे ग्रंथों ने कही है, सत्यम वद धर्मम चर। तो सत्यम वद और धर्मम चर ये दो अलग अलग इंस्ट्रक्शंस नहीं है। सत्यम वद का ही अर्थ है धर्मम चर। जैसे ही आप सच बोलना शुरू करते हैं, आप धर्म के रास्ते पर, आप नीति के रास्ते पर, आप एक एथिकल लाइफ के रास्ते पर आप निकल पड़ते हैं। तो चाहे गांधी जी हों, चाहे शास्त्री जी हों, चाहे गौतम बुद्ध हों, चाहे श्री राम हों, जिनके लिए कहा जाता है कि रघुकुल रीत सदा चली आई, प्राण जाई पर वचन न जाई। तो ये जो सत्य वचन, सत्य निष्ठा, ये आज के दिन बहुत ही हमारे लिए एक प्रेरणा का स्रोत होना चाहिए। हम देखते हैं कि हमें एक झूठ के प्रति हम इतने इम्यून हो जाते हैं, वी आर सो इम्यूनाइज्ड टू टॉकिंग द अनट्रूथ, दैट समटाइम्स इवन फॉर स्मॉल स्मॉल थिंग्स वी टेंड टू टेल लाइज, सेइंग हाउ शुड द अदर पर्सन नो व्हाट इज द ट्रूथ। But that's a very wrong approach, because as I explained in the beginning, the moment you want to tell an untruth, you have to spend your energy twice. So my today is a very, very relevant day today for this, to say that we should all go by this word, Satyanishtha. Let me come back a little bit to express the gratitude of Bharati Vidya Bhavan to our former chairpersons, Shri Yardi ji, jinhone janni he Punya sarkhya shaharat he atishay sundar hi sanstha ubhi keli 1980 pasun 2001 paryant, म्हणजे जवळजवळ 16 वर्ष त्यांनी ह्या संस्थेला एक लीडरशिप दिली। ही प्रोव्हाइडेड एन एक्सलंट लीडरशिप अँड सॉ टू इट दॅट धिस इन्स्टिट्यूट स्टँड्स ऑन अ व्हेरी व्हेरी फर्म फुटिंग। नेक्स्ट केम श्री सहस्रबुद्धेजी, हू वॉज अ लेफ्टनंट जनरल व्हेन ही रिटायर्ड फ्रॉम हिज सर्व्हिस। And as I learned from some of the teachers, he was a very disciplined person, so he introduced lot of good disciplines in the management of this institute. For example, the monthly meetings, the proper rapport between the staff and the executive committee, which was also there with Mr. Yardi. All the three of them, Rubhai sir, who was with us till few months back, all of them, I am told, used to take very keen interest in the well-being of not only the two schools, but also the entire staff. They always treated the staff as their family members and were always ready to listen to all the suggestions, all the grievances, all the problems of the staff. They were always very, very careful and truly from their heart, they were very careful to appreciate all the good work of the teachers, the students, and were very, very encouraging in their nature for all the staff and the students. So also Mr. Rairikar, who has held the office as secretary, a very able secretary, and now we have another very able secretary, Shri Kakirde. So I feel that today being the foundation day of the Bharati Vidya Bhavan, it's also the day to remember and say our gratitude, express our gratitude to these four people who are not with us anymore, Shri Yardi ji, Shri Sasrabuddhe ji, Shri Dubhashi ji, and Shri Rairikar ji. And let us take a promise that Bharati Vidya Bhavan Pune Kendra will grow to other glorious heights. I was very impressed by what my colleague Srimati Vijayan expressed, and she said that we should have an attitude, or we should try to have a program of adopting certain other areas where, as an experiment, the Bharati Vidya Bhavan schools will try to bring up some kind of improvement. It could be the improvement of one particular lane near our school. It could be the improvement of one particular village near our school, some such thing, but something where our children have a practical experience of sharing their knowledge, their energy, their value system with the energy, knowledge, and value system of the surrounding society, which is today not active part of the school, but we would like their contribution, collaboration, and participation just for the purpose of building a goodwill relationship. So I'm very thankful to Madam Vijayam also, and I take this opportunity to once again congratulate all the presenters here who have presented the Bharati Vidya Bhavan song, the opening prayer, and the prayer which was very, very a favorite prayer of Gandhiji, Raghupati Raghava Rajaram, and all these people who have made this day a very, very memorable, one more memorable day, I should say, in the history of Bharati Vidya Bhavan Pune Kendra. I thank everybody, and let us wish ourselves another good year, which will be free of COVID. And this is perhaps one occasion where I should end up with my last sentence by saying that once this COVID situation is over and the children start coming to the school as usual, we should also have a session with the students about what has been our experience as a country about COVID management, corona management, and what are the experiences or what are the thoughts which came to all of us, especially the students. How have they coped up with this situation? Because if we are able to do this documentation, then this documentation will be a guideline for maybe another 100-200 years. And this is also another project which we should take up when the days are good and when there is no corona. So let us hope and pray that this Diwali onward, we will have a corona-free India. Thank you very much. I will end with a small prayer. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kaschit dukha bhag bhavet. Jai Hind, namaskar.
रत्ना, आपके प्रेरणादायक शब्दों के लिए आपको सभी की ओर से अशेष धन्यवाद मैडम. मे आई नाउ रिक्वेस्ट आवर हेडमिस्ट्रेस परांजपे नर्सरी स्कूल श्रीमती अपर्णा यलनारकर टू प्रपोज द वोट ऑफ थैंक्स.
थैंक यू रत्ना मैडम. इट इज इंडीड अ मोमेंटस डे टुडे फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस at Bhavans, and it is my privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this occasion. On behalf of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan Pune Kendra, I thank our Honorable Chairperson Leena Mehendale Madam for gracing today's function. Thank you, Madam, for your enlightening words. I wish to express my gratitude to the Vice Chairperson of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan Pune Kendra, Srimati Vijayam Karta Madam, for her esteemed presence and valuable guidance always extended. My heartfelt thanks to the Director and Honorary Secretary of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan Pune Kendra, Professor Nandakumar Kakide sir, for his unwavering support and encouragement at every point of time. My sincere thanks to all the honorable members of Bhavans Pune Kendra Committee. I thank the heads of various units of Bhavans Pune Kendra for their esteemed presence. A special thanks to the Bhavans Muktangan Exploratory Team for the technical support extended. My heartfelt thanks to all the wonderful teachers of Bhavan Schools who have contributed to the growth of this institution. Thank you so much, dear teachers, for all the hard work and energy that you always put in to make learning meaningful and enjoyable for the students. I extend my hearty wishes to all the members of the Bhavans family on the occasion of the Foundation Day. Thank you.